client. My name is Liv. Today we have a weighted Pilates session. So I have my 1.5 kilo hand weights. You could use any weight that's appropriate for your strength. You could even have a few options if that's available to you. If you don't have hand weights at home, you can use water bottles filled up. You could use cans of food. You could use those little wrist weights, those ankle weights that we wrap around our wrists and ankles sometimes. Otherwise, if you've got nothing to use at all, that's fine. You can still do this workout. It will still be effective. So we're going to sit up with our legs out in front of us, knees bent, feet flat, one weight in each hand, reaching those arms out to your shoulder height. So we're coming into our C curve and roll back. So you want to drop your ribs to your hips, roll yourself back to your halfway. So not too far. We want to feel that core working. Now can you draw that left elbow back open towards the left? Reach forward, draw the right arm back, and reach. Now you're sitting all the way up, lengthening through your spine. Let's do that again. Drop the ribs to the hips, tuck the tailbone round through the spine, pull in through the core, pull the left elbow, rotate, and reach. Pull the right, reach. Bring yourself up. So already I'm feeling the tops of my shoulders going up here, as well as of course my core. Nice, we're just doing two more. Rolling back, pause, pull that belly in, reach and low. Amazing, last one. Let's roll back, hold, pull that left elbow back. Right. Now we're going to sit up one last time and we're rolling back all the way down together. So drop ribs to hips, roll all the way back onto your back, reach your arms up toward the sky, head flat on the mat. Perfect. Now we only need one leg for this next exercise, so popping one down, step your feet in a little closer towards you, holding this weight sideways now, reaching arms towards the sky above your chest. So let's curl, let's tuck the chin. Exhale, lift head, neck and shoulders, reaching that leg before your knees. And then relax back down. Beautiful, exhale, ribs to hips, lift up into that curl. And release. Nice, so trying to get those shoulder blades off the mat. And rather than using momentum, nice and controlled with that weight. Perfect. We've got three more here before we add on. Two. Beautiful. Shoulders down away from ears. Last three. Now let's add on. So as we curl, lift your left leg to tabletop. Hold the curl, reach the leg long, reach the arms behind the head. Pull everything back in. And then place the foot down, reset, place your head down. So we'll alternate our legs. This time it's right leg curl. Hold that curl. to the left, keep pressing down through the opposite shoulder blade. Big squeeze through the right side of the legs, draw down through the lower back, bring the legs back to the middle. Let's lower the legs to the other side, over to the right. Stretch out through the side of the body, and then squeeze through that same side, draw down through the core, legs back through center. So we'll keep going here, just making sure your knees are staying stuck and we're not losing that top knee, it's not sliding back. Always keeping both shoulder blades pressing down. Perfect. Now as we bring legs back to center, we're going to pause there, press the arms to the sky, pull back out wide, and then lower to the second side. So you've got your pendulum, we come through center, we take the chest press, we pull out wide. Pendulum, we pull back through center, chest press up, squeezing through the chest and biceps, pulling out wide. One more. As we chest press, we're adding a single or a double toe tap. So you can do a single and just alternate those toe taps or both toes tapping down as you press to the sky, back to tabletop as you bend your elbows and then lower your legs. Perfect. Nice. So adding in these hand weights is a really good way to make sure we're getting body workout with our Pilates class, especially if we're low on time. We can only fit 20 minute class in. This ensures that we've got lower body, core, and upper body all working at once. Awesome. Let's go for four more toe taps. Beautiful. This is three. Should be firing up. Two. And let's make that our last one. Toe tap press. Now keep your arms straight, turn your palms in, bring your legs back to tabletop and straighten the knees. So feet point towards the ceiling. Let's fly our arms out to the side at a 45 degree angle and squeeze through the chest to close. Open. And close. Lower back pressing down, ribs drawing to hips. From here, separate your legs to hip distance apart, single, straight leg and lower as the arms open and close. Alternate those legs. Lower, close. Beautiful. If straight legs is a little too much, too long of a lever, you can go toe tap, so knees will be bent.
Squeezing through that hamstring so you don't drop the weight. Hands shoulder.
going to kick your heel through the ceiling. Take it easy, make sure you don't go too quick and drop that weight. Let's pulse for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, and 3, 2, 1, draw it in. Perfect. Now, not quite done here, we'll circle that leg. So I want you to press your heel back to the sky, open your knee out, and circle down. I'm going to take a pointed toe for this exercise. You do what works for you. Now we're working in through our obliques as well, making sure we're not rocking over to the opposite direction, over to that left side. And we're working into that hip mobility. Beautiful, and reverse those circles. Lift out to the sky, back behind, and down. Eight more. As big as you can. That's it, last five, four, three, two, one. Last big circle. And bring it down. Nice job. Let's grab that weight. Moving straight on just the side. Line work. Today we're propped up on the elbow and forearm. Elbow directly on the shoulder. Knees bent, feet together. Weight is just going to rest on your top thigh. And we're moving into our plans. So we don't want to hold the weight with our hand because that defeats the purpose. We just gently balance that weight on our top thigh so that we feel that extra resistance as we open. Beautiful. Now can you lift your waist up away from the mat? Perfect. Beautiful. Drawing the core in. Feeling that big squeeze as you open. Taking five.
Workout twice through,
one that's pulse here. You might actually be feeling this a lot more in your supporting leg. I definitely am. It did work really hard just then, and it's still working hard to keep our body nice and stable. Let's pulse that left leg for another four, three, two, one. Bring it down. Beautiful. Now let's circle. Press the heel to the sky. Open the knee. Circle down and around. Press, open, down, and around. And press it into both hands, especially that left hand. Drawing in through the waist and in through the core. Perfect. Let's reverse those circles out to the side, up and down. Making sure we're not swinging our body too much. Isolating that left leg and glute. It's getting tough now. Let's go for four. Big circles. Three, as big as you can. Two. One. And bring it down. Amazing. Grab your weight. Come down onto your side. Let's get into those biting clamps. Set yourself up. Elbow under shoulder. Waist lifted. Knees bent. Feet in line with the body. Weight on that top leg. Just balancing with the hand. Not gripping around. Big squeeze to open. And release. Amazing. Press your heels together. Squeeze that top glute to open. Feeling that waist lift up. Good, let's just do four more here. Three, pulse is coming up in two. And we've made it on one. Let's pulse for five, four, three, two, one. Lower the knee to hip height. Lift the foot to hip height. Step the leg out straight. Lower the leg. Lift the leg. Keeping that leg at parallel. So the top of the foot is pointing forward. Really just try and rest the fingers on that weight as well. Big squeeze, that's it. Almost there. Reach through the leg, through the foot. We're pulsing in five, four, three, two. Got it. Lift on one. Pulse five, four, three, two, one. Grab your weight. Reach your arm overhead. Look down and then pull into elbow and extend. Draw in. Nine, keep that leg lifted, shoulder down, away from the knee. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, that's it, we've done it. We're at one. Beautiful, bring it down, come on up now. Quick little cardio burst before we wrap things up completely. So we've got just one weight to keep it simple. One leg to the left side of your mat. Hands are going to be shoulder width or slightly wider. Coming to your high plank. From here, quad press. Bend your knees, send your weight back to your heels, and then shoot forward to your plank. Now reach that right arm underneath your left, pick up the weight, pop it down on the floor. Let's do that again with the left hand. Grab the weight, pop it down. Hands flat, quad press. Shoot forward, reach that way, place it down. Do that with the left hand, place it down. And let's go, quad press, forward. Now if you'd like to pick up the pace, be my guest. Keep that technique though, core lifting. Try not to rock too much side to side. I'm just being mindful of my microphone here, so don't mind me. But you want stretch. Slow down the breath. Come all the way up, jump. Now we'll take a glute stretch before we wrap things up. So any glute stretch that you love, I'm just doing it seated today. So coming into that finger four stretch, legs out in front. Left ankle crosses over right knee. Flips the left foot back. Kickstand with my arms and press the chest open. And if I do want more, I'm just going to bring myself closer to that right foot. Nice job. You can do this in your sleep and swan variation. So leg out in front, right leg behind, taking that forward fold. You can do this position on your back. Whatever works for you. Just switching sides when you're ready. Taking any other stretches you feel like your body needs as well before you finish up class. And once you're done there, you are all done with the class as well. So I really hope you enjoyed this weighted Pilates session. If you did, please make sure to like my video and subscribe to my channel so we can keep doing Pilates together. Have an amazing day and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.